It is my great honor, ladies and gentlemen, to share the announcement that as part of a landmark 100-year agreement between the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the New York Public Library, the National Constitution Center will display one of the 12 surviving copies of the Bill of Rights.
Most people, if they were asked about the Bill of Rights, they would say it's our Constitution. I mean, it is the basic, what people know about our Constitution is embedded in these 10 amendments. I also happen to be the chairman of the National Constitution Center, and I'm very honored to do so because it is a unique institution. It'll be the place that will first host this treasured document in the fall of 2014.
Anytime you have a document or you have an actual piece of history that you can show people allows you to tell the story. And once a document that's been, you know, that's been away from public view for so long now is in the public light, you have a chance all over to tell the story and really articulate what it means to us as Americans.
The Bill of Rights is the basic charter of our fundamental rights and liberties. Think about the right to free speech, the right against unreasonable searches and seizures, the right to a fair trial. All of these are enumerated not in the original Constitution, but in the first 10 amendments to the Constitution, and those are called the Bill of Rights.
It is one of the most profound documents in the history of humankind. It is one that is emulated by many countries and nations around the world.
I ended up, at the end of this process, impressed by the maturity of the leadership of the New York Public Library, by the steadfastness of our own governor, and by the support that we were getting all the way through from the National Constitution Center's Board of Trustees.
This is a win-win for the people of New York and the people of Pennsylvania and people who come from all over the world. And we'll hope they'll be inspired by it.
What a great relationship between the Commonwealth and the New York Public Library to say that, you know, we're both working in the public interests, and when we have the ability to share a document and to be able to both tell the story, we think we could be more powerful that way.
A Bill of Rights is what the people are entitled to against every government, and what no just government should refuse or rest on inference. Thomas Jefferson.
The National Constitution Center's mission is to be both the museum of we the people and America's town hall, a place where citizens can come here in Philadelphia and on the web and on radio and television and learn about the best arguments on both sides of all our current constitutional debates. This spectacular copy of the Bill of Rights will anchor those constitutional conversations.
In terms of civic education, this is a spectacular deal. And the idea that there's a tangible document, I think, is a magnet to build all sorts of intangible things around it. So I'm excited about that. It's pretty cool.
The truth is, after all the declamations we have heard, that the Constitution is itself, in every rational sense and to every useful purpose, a Bill of Rights. Alexander Hamilton.
To have the Bill of Rights, the authentic document that enumerates the rights of the citizens is extremely exciting.
I think it's a great opportunity to bring a new story. And at the Constitution Center, we try to tell great stories. So to be able to tell a story that we haven't told before about the Bill of Rights and that part of the founding of our country, I think it's just another great draw to add to what's already a great visitor destination.
The public will be able to see this priceless document at the National Constitution Center starting in 2014. We are constructing a magnificent new exhibition hall to showcase it and to have other programs to discuss our rights and liberties, and it'll be here for 3 years.